Since 1996, conflict in eastern DRC has led to approximately 6 million deaths. The First Congo War began in the wake of the 1994 Rwandan genocide, during which ethnic Hutu extremists killed an estimated 1 million minority ethnic Tutsis and moderate Hutus in Rwanda. During and following the genocide, nearly 2 million Hutu refugees crossed the Congolese border, mostly settling in refugee camps in the North Kivu and South Kivu provinces. A small subset of those Rwandans who entered DRC were Hutu extremists who began organizing militias within the Congo. Pressure intensified as Tutsi militias organized against the Hutu groups and as foreign powers began taking sides. Hello, welcome to the channel and make sure to subscribe for more content. The Democratic Republic of Congo experienced a spike in violence in the latter months of 2023, as the country anticipated national elections in December. Clashes involving militant groups over territory and natural resources, extrajudicial killings by security forces, political violence, and rising tensions with neighboring Rwanda, mostly regarding its alleged support for militia groups in Congo, have contributed to the deadly conflict. In addition to reports of mounting civilian deaths in eastern Congo, the UN declared that the number of internally displaced people had reached a record high of 6.9 million as fighting renders a growing part of the country unsafe for civilians. One of the most prominent rebel groups to emerge in the early 2000s was known as the March 23rd Movement, M23, made up primarily of ethnic Tutsis. Between 2012 and 2013, M23 became an undeniable force in eastern DRC, and Kinshasa accused Kigali of backing the group. In 2013, the UN Security Council authorized a rare offensive brigade under the mandate of the UN Organization Stabilization Mission in the DRC to support the Congolese army in its fight against M23. Evidence of Rwanda's support for M23 caused lasting damage to the Kigali-Kinshasa relationship. Other flashpoints have arisen over the past two decades in states on the Congo-Rwanda border, such as Ituri, most often involving ethnic and militant groups with contestations going back to the Congo Wars. The 21st century brought one more complication to peace efforts in the Democratic Republic of Congo: the proliferation of mining operations. DRC is home to some of the world's largest reserves of metals and rare earth minerals used to produce advanced electronics. As the world has become more reliant than ever on cobalt, copper, zinc, and other minerals, local and external groups have become more incentivized to get involved in the Congolese conflict. The abundance of natural resources, especially precious minerals, found in Congolese soil has globalized the conflict in eastern DRC. While U.S. companies once owned vast cobalt mines in the Congo, most were sold to Chinese companies during the Barack Obama and Donald Trump administrations. Chinese companies connected to Beijing now control the majority of foreign-owned cobalt, uranium, and copper mines in DRC, and the Congolese army has been repeatedly deployed to mining sites in eastern DRC to protect Chinese assets. The Joe Biden administration has acknowledged that China's virtual monopoly in DRC's mining industry plays a significant role in boosting China's comparative advantage in the energy and technology arenas, and is a hindrance to U.S. clean energy aspirations.